Hey guys, JR Raymond back again, coming to you from Classic Lanes in Rochester Hills, Michigan. Today I want to talk to you about one of the most misunderstood things in bowling, and that's playing the inside part of the ball. What does that even mean? Let's talk about it. All right, welcome back. So we've all watched the PBA, we've seen the TV shows where Randy Peterson's on there and he's talking and giving tips in certain segments of the show. And one of the big things he constantly brings up is how professionals play the inside part of the ball and the amateurs play the outside most times. And what he means by that is actually where your fingers are positioned at the bottom of the release. So when you look at somebody, if I show you here quick, if I've got my hand just in a house ball, from behind, if I look, or if you look at me, most amateurs, they'll finish this way. Now you can look at where my fingers are on the outside part of the ball. It's to the outside. What he's trying to say is that you should have your fingers to the inside. And the reason you should be at the inside is because then you have more room for rotation. You can rotate from here all the way around, and the amount of power you can put into the ball from here to here is completely different than if you're already here and now all you're doing is just going through the ball. Gaining revolutions and gaining extra spin on the ball is really, really hard to do if you're here already on top of the ball with your fingers to the outside. But if your fingers are to the inside, over here like this, now you can rotate and throw that frisbee like I talked about in the rev rate video. So playing the inside part of the ball is important, not just for power, but it actually makes it a little bit easier to be consistent in having being able to be a little bit more versatile on the lanes as well. So you can go from way inside and be able to hook the entire lane to being more outside and playing up the lane. If you're like most people who play the outside part of the ball, when you have your hand to the outside part of the ball, you tend to play further right more often and you tend to struggle as you move left. So the next time you're practicing and the next time you get yourself caught on video, look at where your hand is at the bottom of the swing. If your hand is to the outside part of the ball, more likely than not, you're one of those guys or gals who really like to play straight and are having trouble when you move further left. If you want to learn to play further left on the lane, you need to get your hand to the inside part of the ball. What's the easiest way to do that? Well, there's all kinds of tricks and tools that you can get, like what we talked about before with the wrist restrictor by Turbo, where you can get your hand forced to stay to the inside and it won't let you go to the outside. But the mindset, the thought behind this is to really think about your elbow and your fingers. Point the elbow, your point of your elbow, towards your hip as long as possible. The longer you point your elbow into your hip, the easier it is for your hand to get here. But as soon as you go outside, as soon as your elbow goes outward, your hand has to go inward. It's hard to get your fingers to be the inside with your elbow pointing outside. See what I'm saying? So try and think about your elbow staying at the point of your hip the entire way. So as you come through the shot, everything is there in line with the point of your elbow at your hip, and your fingers have the ability to be the inside. If your point of your elbow is to the inside and your fingers are the outside, that means you're really breaking your wrist down, and we need to talk about how we can correct that. So we'll take a little bit more of a look later, but this is just real quick to get you to understand the difference between the inside and the outside part of the ball. So if you have questions, make sure to ask. I'm sure somebody, if not me, can answer your questions down in the chat below. But until next time, guys, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Make sure to hit that like and hit that bell so you get all the notifications on this. And head over to Bowling Faithfully as well. I got a link up here somewhere. It's a little circle with the, you know, my logo in it. Make sure to hit that bell and like that channel as well, as we do some different types of videos over there. So stay tuned. Tomorrow we're going to probably bring something new out. I have some announcements to make, so stay tuned on that. And we're going to announce the winner of the Dexter shoes tomorrow as well. So stay tuned, pay attention, and we will see you guys later.